Salman al-Farisi, he comes to Al-Madinah. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam made him brothers, because when the companions moved to Al-Madinah, the ones from Mecca, the Ansar, I mean the Muhajirun, when they came, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam made everyone brothers. They could inherit from one another. Everyone had to help one another because they were a new community. So Salman al-Farisi, he had to live with, or he was living with, he was living with Abu Darda. Abu Darda is from the Ansar. So then after he saw Abu Darda's wife, and she was, as the hadith states, mutabadhila. She was like, she looked like she was not worn out. She looked like she did a hard day's work, and she was mutabadhila. She was wearing the clothes of a person who did work, hard work in that day, maybe working on a farm or something like that, because in Al-Madinah, they were farmers. So when she saw him, what did she say? She said, sahibuka, or something like that, Abu Darda, laysa lahu hajatun fi dunya. That Abu Darda, he has no haja for the dunya. He's not involved in the dunya. He doesn't do anything that's dunya based. So then Abu Darda, he came and he knew that his guest Salman was here. He gave him food. What did he say to Salman? He said, "Kul fa inni sa'im." Eat, I'm fasting. That's what he said to Salman. Salman al-Farisi, after seeing Abu Darda maybe doing a whole day's work, said, "Kul la akulu hatta ta'kul." I'm not going to eat until you eat. And then after he made Abu Darda break his fast. Do you understand? Khalas. So then they went to sleep. They went to sleep. Salman al-Farisi went to sleep. And then Abu Darda said, he went up to go to pray. Abu Darda went to go to pray. Salman al-Farisi said, "Nam." Okay, nam, sleep, like sleep. You know, what are you trying to do tahajjud for? Sleep. So he slept. When there was a second portion of the night, he got up. Okay. Salman al-Farisi said to him again, "Nam, sleep." And then he went back to sleep. And then when it was akhirul layl, third part of the night, they both got up. Now he got up. And then the hadith states, فَصَلَّيَا. They prayed Qiyam al-Layl together. Can you see? One person has ilm, and one person, he has hamasa. He's a good, pious man. But Salman al-Farisi, it's not that Salman al-Farisi has been Muslim much longer, but maybe he's heard the Prophet ﷺ say something, and he's traveled, like he's been through different experiences. He's older maybe, he's traveled, and he's had to literally go from, you know, earth, land and sea to get to here. So his fahm is different. He's saying, yani, you have to be consistent in your Islam. You can't do, you're gonna burn out if you do what you do. So after fasallaya, after they prayed, what did he say? He said, "Inna rabbaka alayka haqqa." He said, "Your Rabb, your Lord, he has haqq upon you. Wali ahlika alayka haqqa. And your family, they have a haqq upon you. وَلِجَسَدِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ وَلِبَدَنِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ." And if your body has a haqq upon you, فَعْطِي كُلَّ ذِي حَقٍ حَقَّ. Give every single part of your portion of your body is haqq, is right. Do you understand? So, yeah, and you can't. It's not how it works. And even when he said, "Your Rabb has a haqq upon you," Allah only wants you to pray five times a day, bare minimum. As-salah, for even a normal person here, after you do wudu and all that, salah is 5 minutes. Apart from Maghrib and Isha, maybe if you're praying in the masjid or whatever, but especially something like Dhuhr, Asr, if you're just praying on your own or whatever, it's 5 minutes. So even when it comes to the haqq that you give to Allah, Allah is Al-Hakim. He only wants a bit of time from you. Allah never said, "Give me my haqq," and you have no haqq for yourself. Allah has allowed you to have your haqq. وَلِأَهْلِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقٍّ. And even your family have a haqq upon you. وَلِجَسِدِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقٍّ. Even your jasad, your body has haqq. You can't, يعني, you're not going to, even a marathon runner, he has to sleep and sometimes have rest days. And even when it comes to your jasad, has haqq. فَعْطِي كُلَّ ذِي حَقٍ حَقَّ. Give every bit of your body is right. Abu Darda went to Prophet ﷺ and told him what Salman said. See, this from Salman's ijtihad. The Prophet ﷺ say, "Sadaqah Salman." Salman spoke the truth. So it's like this, what we're trying to say was a approval.